Time now for some news, and generally what we bring you from the biking world is upbeat and interesting and aspirational, and more often than not involves shiny new models or brilliant shiny new people like the Binders we had on the programme last week. But unfortunately we have some genuinely sad news this week, and it concerns old bikes. Regular viewers may remember that last summer I found myself travelling through Austria when I decided to take a detour to visit the highest altitude museum in Europe. Situated very near the summit of the Timmelshoch Pass that crosses from Austria into Italy, the Top Mountain Museum, as it's called, is home to a stunning collection of classic bikes that are housed in a truly beautiful building that spans the mountain pass itself. Some of that beauty comes down to the fact that it's a wooden construction, as are many of the buildings in the Austrian Alps. Unfortunately, the anti-flame properties of wood aren't very good, as was demonstrated on the morning of January the 18th when the building was engulfed by fire. The fire was noticed at 4:30 in the morning by a couple of staff living on the premises who tried to deal with it but couldn't and called the fire department, which isn't exactly just around the corner when you're situated at the summit of an Alp. When they got there, the ceiling was already on fire, and although 60 firefighters using water cannons and even snow blowers tried, there wasn't much to be done. The building is definitely toast, and thankfully nobody was hurt, but as for the exhibits, it's difficult to find any definitive answers. The museum housed about 230 classic bikes, many of them extremely rare, and it unfortunately seems a possibility that absolutely none of them survived. I made a short video over the Christmas break to be shown in the next few weeks about the history of the Indian Scout, because when I did visit last summer there was a temporary Indian exhibition. I don't know if those bikes were still there at the time of the fire, but I'll show those bikes on the programme in the near future. In the meantime, I thought I'd share with you a brief overview of just a few of the extraordinary bikes from this incredible collection to give you a taste of the historical jewels that made up the Top Mountain Museum. The range of bikes in here from the very beginning of motorised two-wheel transport over a century ago is, or was, truly amazing. I spent several hours during my visit here pointing my cameras at one extraordinary bike after another, like this 1911 1-litre V-twin Flying Merkel from the heyday of American board racing. Or how about this Militaire, also American-made in 1915, that features an 1145cc inline four-cylinder engine, some seriously convoluted steering and wooden wheels. There were collections of bikes from Italy, the UK and Germany grouped together, a gaggle of Brough Superiors, a flock of Indians as well, including this Camelback from 1905. Here's another 1905 model in the shape of this wonderful Lorin and Clement 544cc V-twin from the former Austro-Hungarian Empire. And look at this, a fantastic NSU race bike from 1939. A 250 with 15 horsepower and a fairing to make you dream of speed and glory and champions of the past. Makes me very, very sad looking back at those images. It's a real tragedy that these historical artifacts and the stories and the people that they represent have been erased from existence. We can only hope that at least some were rescued. When we learn more, we'll let you know. Right, before I start blubbering, after the break, some uplifting news about a new breed of South African heroes.